This is Adi Sharma, Class 12, Solutions, Chapter 9, Continuity, VSAQ Very Short Answer Questions. If fx is equal to these two functions, one is the constant. When x is not equal to 4, and x equals 4. So this is continuous at x equals 4. So we have to find k. So what we have to do here is, we'll just take the limit. Let me tell you once again, just to recall, that limit extends to 4, x square minus 16 by x minus 4. This should be equal to f4, that is fa. What is f4 here? When you put 4, you get k. So whatever is the result, that will be equal to k. So we have to essentially solve this limit. So x square minus 16 can be written as x square minus 4 square by x minus 4. X minus 4, x plus 4, a minus b, a plus b. X minus 4 in the denominator, you can cancel this out. X plus 4 is there. So limit extends to 4. X plus 4, and just apply the limit. In place of x, just replace it by 4. 4 plus 4 is 8. So k is equal to 8. Determine whether this fx, the point of contention is 0. So it is not equal to 0 sin x square by x, 0 when it is 0. So whether it is continuous or not at x, that we have to find out. So if it is continuous, see, limit x tends to a, in case of, in this case we have a as 0, sin x square by x, this has to be equal to fa, a is 0. So this is equal to f0, and f0 is what? When you put 0, it is already given in the question, it is 0. So we have to solve this. Sin x square by x. So multiply the numerator and denominator by x. Why? Because we need x square in the denominator. Because we know what is the limit of sin theta by theta when limit theta tends to 0. That is, limit theta tends to 0, sin theta by theta. So, you know, sin inverse is also same. I'll just tell you in the coming question. So let's apply the limit. Theta tends to 0, sin x square by x square. When x is 0, x square will be equal to 0. So you can also say limit x tends to 0. But here, we have this x is extra. Limit x tends to 0 because we have by ourselves introduced this x. 1 into 0 is 0. Okay. So what do you get here? This is continuous at x equal to 0, but because it is equal to f0. So this is how you are going to write. Okay, the logic I gave you, but the writing is on the left hand side which I showed you. If fx is this, when x is not equal to 0, when x is equal to 0, it is going to be k. And this is continuous at x equal to 0, we have to find k. So let me give you again the definition for continuity. Limit x tends to a, this fx, if it is equal to fa, a is 0 here. So this will be the condition for continuity. Necessary and sufficient. So limit x tends to 0, 1 minus cos x divided by x square. Fa is what? F0 is what? It is k. It is already given in the question. So whatever we solve here, that we will equate to k. 1 minus cos theta is what? Actually, it is 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sin square theta. But since we have this 1 minus cos theta, we can write it as 2 sin square x by 2. In the denominator, you already have x square, which you want. But we need 4 in the denominator, so we multiplied the 4 also. So I'm just taking this 2 by 4, which is half outside. Now limit, what do we have? This is sine x by 2 and divided by x by 2 and this whole square. Sine theta by theta whole square. So sine theta by theta, we already told you just now. Limit theta tends to 0, sine theta by theta is 1. So you have half. And this is equal to k. So this is on the left hand side. I showed you actually how you have to write everything. if fx equals sin inverse x by x. So before we go ahead in solving this, limit x tends to 0, this is sin inverse x by x, this is equal to 1. Okay, so the definition we already know. So limit, I'll directly write a as 0 here. So limit x tends to 0, sin inverse x by x, and this is equal to fa, a is 0 in this case, f0, and that is given in the question as k. So k will be equal to sin inverse by inverse x by x, limit x tends to 0. And I told you already it is equal to 1, so k is equal to 1. Write the value of b for which this function fx is continuous at x equals 1. So if you make a number line, you see there are 2 points here. Actually 3 points, 0, 1, 2. So 0, 1, if you go to the left of 1, 1 is inclusive in 5x minus 4. So the function number 1, which is 5x minus 4, the second number function, if you go just ahead of 1, you will take 4x square plus 3bx and below 2, of course. So the point of contention of continuity checking is 1. So we'll find out the limit, left hand limit, right hand limit. We'll equate them and then we'll equate it to the value of the function at this 1, f1. So LHL, RHL. So this will give you continuity along with the value of the function at 1. So f1 I'm talking about, right? Okay. So let us check this, and since the point is 1, so f1, before going ahead, f1 is what? Where is the equality sign? It is at 5x minus 4. So just put 1 in place of x. 5 into 1 minus 4, that is going to be 1. F1 is 1. So LHL, RHL will equate it to 1. Okay. Let's find out LHL. Now since the point is 1, so we'll take left hand side, so 1 minus h we have to take, right hand side we have to take 1 plus h. So x is equal to 1 minus h on the left hand side, 1 plus h on the right hand side. This is left hand limit and right hand limit. We are just going just a point below and above, it's just h, which is very small, equivalent to 0. So I'm replacing this 1 minus h in 5 into 1 minus h minus 4, because we have to take the first function, because we are going on the back side of 1 or behind 1. Let us apply the limit. Limit h tends to 0. 5h is 0. 5 minus 4 is 1. So left hand limit is 1, which is equal to f1 also. Right hand limit. For that we have to use 4x square plus 3bx. This function we have to use. So 4 into 1 plus h whole square plus 3b 1 plus h. So 4 a square plus b square plus 2ab, 1 square plus h square plus 2h plus 3 into b plus 3 into b into h. So 4, 4 plus 4h square plus 8h plus 3b plus 3bh. Now just apply the limit. Wherever h is 0, just you can remove that term. You get 4 plus 3b. Okay, this is right hand limit now. Now this left hand limit and right hand limit we have to equate. So let us equate it with 1. So 4 plus 3b is equal to 1. So 3b equal to 1 minus 4. That is minus 3. B is equal to minus 1. B is negative 1. This is your answer, because b has to be found out. This is how you have to write, okay? Determine the value of the constant k so that the function f, x, and fx is given like this. Kx by mod x if x is less than 0. And if it is x greater than or equal to 0, it has to be 3. So what is the way? Left hand limit, right hand limit, equate with the value of the function at that particular point, which is 0 here. So left hand limit, right hand limit, right hand limit we won't be finding, because it is already a constant 3. That is, if you have 0 left hand limit, you will take kx by mod x. But right hand limit, it is already 3, because at x is greater than or equal to 0, it is 3. And what is the value of the function at 0? It is already given as 3. because equality is x is greater than or equal to 0, that is at 3. So x is mod x is x greater than 0 minus x if x is less than 0. So left hand limit we will find out, or you can say just limit we will find out, and good to find out the left hand limit. X tends to 0 minus, or you can say 0 minus h, x equals 0 minus h we'll put. This is how we write. So this is k into 0 minus h divided by 0 minus h. This is I'm replacing. So x is less than 0 is what? We already know x is less than 0, mod x will be negative x. Okay. And since we already are using this 0 minus h with modulus, numerator will be minus k into h, denominator will be, since it is minus h, the modulus will always give you a positive sign for a negative one, so it will be h. Now you can cancel this h out, you will get a negative k. So limit h tends to 0, so minus k it is. Okay, what is this equal to? 3. As I told you already, it is equal to 3. So this is equal to 3, k is equal to minus 3. This is your answer. But you have to write like this. On the left hand side, you see the solution. Find the value of k for which the function fx is equal to this. Is continuous at x equals 2. So it is very clear here that is continuous at x equals 2. So we are talking about a point 2. And since it is not equal to 2, so you don't have to go for LHL or RHL, because you just have to find out the limit. So we will just find out limit at x tends to 2 for x square plus 3x minus 10 divided by x minus 2. And we have to equate it with k. It is equal to fa, a is 2 here, f2. And question is saying when x is equal to 2. Actually, this is x equals 2. So this is already given as k. So whatever is the solution of the limit, we'll equate it to k. Let us solve this. So we'll write it as, I'm making the factors, x square plus 5x minus 2x minus 10 divided by x minus 2. So x square, you can take x common, x plus 5 minus 2, x plus 5 divided by x minus 2. So x minus 2, x plus 5 by x minus 2. You can cancel these two, x plus 5. So limit x tends to 2, x plus 5. Apply the limit, 2 plus 5, and this is equal to 7. So k is equal to 7 in this case. This is your answer. You have to write like this on the left hand side, you see the solution, right? Okay, this is all about this VSAQ. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.